Hello friends, my name is Kishan and welcome you in this video tutorial. In previous video tutorial we have discussed about the parallel stream and there we have seen this example. So one key points you will have to keep in mind when you go for the parallel stream, then iteration of your elements, order of iteration of your elements will be not maintained as you have added in this list. So see, if I run this program, then see the order of iteration. SK I have added on fourth position, but this is getting processing first. So basically parallel stream makes use of the multi-thread, and that makes use of as well multi-core processor. So multiple threads are getting spawned internally, and different elements are getting assigned to the different thread for processing. So that's the reason you don't get elements process in the same order as you have added in this list. But if you have a stream instead of parallel stream, if you have a stream, then this will process in the sequential manner. So see, the here order is maintained. So first we have added PK, then KK, MK. So order is basically here preserved when you go for the stream. But in parallel stream, processing will be very faster because that's API is makes use of the multi-thread internally, but order in which elements are getting processed that will not maintain as inserted in this list. So these things you will have to keep in mind. Now next thing we are going to see over here in this slide, stream operations. So there are many useful operations that can be performed on a stream. They are divided into basically two categories. First is intermediate operations, which returns you the stream object itself, and second is the terminal operation, which returns you the result of definite type. That might be a result of integer. Definite type means that may be a return of boolean object, integer, long, any kind of primitive type or wrapper class object type or custom data type. Intermediate operations basically allow you for chaining operation. It's also worth noting that operations on the stream don't change the source. So here is the quick example. Like you have a list, right? You apply, you call a stream method on list, that gives you the list itself. So this is called intermediate operation. Again you are calling distinct method on this list, so again this is called intermediate API. Distinct is also intermediate API. And finally, when you call count, so this gives you the count. So count is considered as a terminal API. So until unless do not call the terminal API on any stream, so you will not get the final result, and this code is not going to executed. Basically stream is executed lazily. So until unless you do not apply any terminal API, entire stream is not going to execute. So let's go ahead and create a Java project, and I would say here stream operation demo. Here I have created this project. Let's create a class in package com.infotech, and class name I'm going to specify client test, which will have a main method. Okay, here basically I'm going to create a list with a string. And I'm going to assign a implementer of list like array list. You are free to choose here any kind of list. There are many implementer of list like linked list, vector and all. Now here I'm going to add some string in this list like shown. Thank you. not in, add some more elements. Entry, right? So here you can add millions of object. Now we know that we have a method, it's called a stream, right? So look at the, this method is declared in the collection interface and whose return type the stream itself. So this is considered as a intermediate operation, right? So this gives you a stream itself, right? Now in this stream, just I'm going to break these things in multiple lines. Now a stream has a method is called distinct, right? Distinct. So which again returns is the string, stream itself, right? So this is also considered a, this is also considered a intermediate operation. Again, if you call this method on distinct, which is a stream itself, count. So here you can see count is returning long return type. And finally you get the count. Count is nothing but the how many elements is held by this list, and you are making use of stream, right? So here you can print the count, right? If I run it, right, so we get the count as a 4. But this operation you can change, right? So you don't, for clear understanding, I have splitted this code into three lines. But here you have a list, you can perform the chaining operations, right? So if your API is returning some intermediate stream, then you can chain the action. Now here you can have a stream, right? We know that a stream is returning a stream of a stream. So a stream, then again you can call the distinct method on this, right? So again this guy is returning a stream of a string itself. So finally you can call distinct, right? A distinct is the terminal operation which returns, distinct is again returning a stream of a string. So this is intermediate operation again. And finally you are calling the count, right? And count is returning you the long data type. This is the very specific data type, right? So now you can clubbed all operation in one chain, and finally you get the count. So if I run it, then you get the almost same output, right? So here get the output. So here basically the distinct method represents an intermediate operation, right, which creates a new stream of unique elements of the previous stream, and count method is a terminal operation which returns you the stream size itself, right? So again I'm going to use another terminal method. So here, now one thing you will have to keep in mind, once you create a stream, right, so a stream cannot be reused. That I wanted to show you, like if here I'm going to write, so just is, and here just I'm replacing this line of code stream, right? So this code is gonna work perfectly fine, right? But this same stream, if you want to use it again, then you'll get an error. So once a stream is consumed, then you cannot add it again, right? So if you call any method on this, like if you call again count method on this, right, so you'll get an error. So if I run it, then you'll get an error. See, look at you. So stream is, once stream is consumed, you cannot use it again. So stream has already been operated upon or closed, right? So this kind of error you'll get. So don't try to use stream again, right? Once stream is consumed, then you cannot use it again. So these things you will have to keep in mind. So next thing I'm going to show you one more method, like you have a list again, and then you can call a stream, right? So if you look at the slide, then another example will have like this, right? So STM API helps you to substitute for each and while loops. It allows concentrated on the operations logic, but not on the iteration over the sequence of elements. For example, suppose if you want to check in list what are the elements contains a string A or character A, then before the Java 0.8 you would have written this kind of code, right? But the code can be changed just with one line of Java 8 code. So here if you have a list, then you can create a stream, and a stream has a method is called AnyMatch, and here just you are passing the lambda expression. If any elements is any elements in this list which contains a letter A, then this will return you true. So that's the advantage of a stream. So here from list we are creating a stream, and then I'm calling any match, right? We can call any match, right? And this guy is returning boolean. So this is a specific type, and but this API is asking me to supply object for predicate. So here I'm passing every elements and checking whether any elements contains some character or not. So here what I'm checking, S arrow, this is a sign of lambda expressions, and I would check contains, right? We have in a string, we have a method is called contains, right? So contains, and here I'm checking any name which contain RK, right? So this gives us, this will give us return as boolean value, and any match I'm trying to print over here, then this should return true, and here we got the true value, but I'm going to change it like this, so this must return as a false, right? So I hope you got this example very well. So that's all I wanted to. Here we have seen two examples, right? And here in this through this example you have learned what is intermediate and what is terminal operations in stream. So that's all I wanted to show in this video tutorial. Next video tutorial we are going to see some more concept on stream. So please be with me over there, and I will request you to please subscribe my YouTube channel so that you'll get intimation about my new video uploads, and you will have more learning. Thanks for watching this video, and see you in next video tutorial.